time's contagious. I've never been this bored before. Is this the prize I've waited for?
You were influenced by Elton John's Greatest Hits. You found that inspiration?
Actually, that was the first. My introduction to rock and roll was the first LP I ever bought. It was, I didn't know anything about him. I still remember the bin. It was like Olivia Newton-John, Elton John, and John Denver. And I remember thinking, Elton John just dressed so cool.
Right.
You know, so basically I picked it up because he had that cool white outfit on. And,
yeah.
And from there on, I've been hooked ever since.
Once again, I just wanted to write songs. The first record I ever bought was Elton John's Greatest Hits. And I just play the record over and over, and I saw what he wrote. Because I grew up in the church, so I didn't know much about, like, you know, and of course I knew Elvis and artists like that, but they didn't really write their songs. So when I saw that Elton and Bernie wrote their own songs, I was like, I just want to write songs.
Have you guys done a lot of collaborations, or have you chose not to collaborate and bring other artists in, or is this kind of a new thing to bring so many people in?
We did it on Blender. We kind of wanted to bring in Atlanta artists at the time, so we had Butch Walker play with us on that, and Chase, and then Elton, of course, was on there. Who else did we
Will's
get?
All I know is that
Did you take credit for Elton?
The day that Elton came in studio, I mean, it was just awesome watching him play, and it was just a great day.
How was that?
And then that song, I still love that song. That one stands up.
Well, you're the keyboard guy, but so is Ed. So, I mean, you were just blown away. I mean, is that dude, like, phenomenal on the keyboards, Elton?
Two takes.
It was literally two really? Takes.
Really? Ripped it.
And I think the first take was fine.
Yeah.
I remember talking Do it one more time because we'd like you.
I was recording a song and I hadn't written the lyrics yet, so I stayed up all night getting the lyrics written. So when he came in, because he came in like at 10 o'clock in the morning, and I was just struggling. And when he came in, he's like, all right, love, what key are we in? And I was like, I was saying like D or something. He goes, let's make it C. I'm like, okay, let's make it
Whatever
C.
Did you say?
Give me 30 minutes to re-record everything real quick. What other bands did you come up when you were starting out that you still remember fondly? Well, first and foremost would be Elton. That's my pop hero. But the highlights from the last 25 years, I would say Elton John playing and singing on a song with us, you know, being your musical hero, and to have him come in and sing was, you know, that's my award for being in music. Who are your greatest musical influences that provide inspiration for your music style, writing, and look? As far as style and writing, I go back to Elton because that's the first one that really caught my interest.
You did a duet with Elton John at one point.
Correct.
Can you tell me about that and what that felt like?
Well, yeah, I grew up, that was my first record I ever bought with my own money, was Elton John's Greatest Hits. It was between him, John Denver, and Olivia Newton-John. It was. That's what was on the rack right there. And I remember going, man, he looks cool. He just, the dress, so I was drawn in by his appearance. And then I got it, and I just kept playing it over and over. And I remember growing up, I was like, I just want to write songs like him, Bernie. And that was my musical hero growing up. Actually, my dad took me to see Elton, too, after Liberace. So during the time when we got signed and things happened for us, I was like, he lives part-time in Atlanta. So us being in Atlanta, I was like, you know, this is my chance. I'm going to see what happens. So I called our publicist at the record company and said, would you just call Elton if he knows who we are? Actually, he had sent somebody through to us when we played Woodstock that he loved us, like he was a big fan. So I was like, okay, this is my chance to meet my hero. So literally within 5 minutes, he called. I picked the phone up and it's, you know, Elton John. And I squealed like a little girl. Like, and ever since then, we've remained in touch. We you know, when paths cross in Atlanta, we go out. And he's always been so kind to us. He's so knowledgeable. And it's always cool to meet your hero because we all know about his music and his stage and his performance. But he's such a great humanitarian and truly a really great man. It's nice that my hero has the whole package. So hopefully I think we get to see him in a couple of weeks. I think our paths cross again. We catch up.
Yeah, he's a Georgia guy now too, isn't he? Like he part-time, lives there part-time. Yeah. Right, yeah. Right.
There was a time I was everything.
Hi Ed, this is Elton. Congratulations on your Youth Catalyst Award. It's been nearly 20 years since we've known each other, since that first collective soul record that I heard shine. And you've been a friend to me since I've been in Atlanta. I love your music, I love you. You're such a good guy. I wish I was there in person to say congratulations, but I'm not. But you know, I love you dearly. And when I get back to Atlanta and you're here, we'll go out to dinner. But have a great evening, you deserve this. Thanks. We'll be right back.